Will Cook here at Holiday World and Splashin' Safari. I'm here on a beautiful January day, January 11th, and as you can see, it's shirt sleeve weather here at Holiday World. I'm standing on the loading platform of the Legend roller coaster. In fact, I'm standing right where the operator will be pressing the button here to send out our first train on May 6th of the year 2000. We're really excited about the Legend, and construction has moved ahead very, very well. The Legend is 95% of the structure is complete. We have steel track work yet to be done. Most of the wooden track work is done as well. So we are certain of being able to open on time on May 6th. And not only that, but to be prepared to host Stark Raven Mad this year on May 5th, the evening before opening. I'd like to take a minute to thank all of you folks who've taken the time and took the time this past spring to send in your ideas and suggestions on how we can make the Legend one of the world's truly great roller coasters. We feel, as construction has proceeded this fall, this summer and fall, we feel that we have accomplished just that. As I've watched parts of the Legend being built in wood, the ideas that we first saw on paper being expressed and raised up into the air, we've become increasingly excited and enthused about this ride. It really is something special. We're tremendously proud of it, and I personally can't wait until we fire it up and take that first ride on it this spring. We think we got a great ride here. Okay, we're going to give you a sense of where we are in the park and kind of how the Legend fits in. The first thing you may want to know is that the Legend is so big we had to put it in two parks. It didn't just fit in Holiday World, so we kind of spread out and branched out into the Splashin' Safari Water Park too. But to get you started, I'm standing here at the Halloween section, kind of below the hill. If you're familiar with Holiday World, below the hill where our high dive theater is and where the Raven Q building is. Behind me is the famous curve number 5 on the Raven. And you can kind of make out between the scrubby low wintertime trees here, the camera where the picture location is on the Raven. So as we head on around, you'll see just how close the double helix on the Legend is to the Raven. The double helix is near the end of the ride, and I think it's the one part that I will take credit that this had to be in the Legend. We went to CCI and started making plans to build this ride. One thing that we absolutely positively were going to have was a double helix. So we're real happy with this. I think it's a very active double helix. It's going to have two tunnels as we go around. The tunnels aren't in place as you look up at it yet, but they will be by opening, and we're very excited about that. And then as we walk on around, then we head towards the lift hill. The lift hill really dominates the skyline in the Halloween section of Holiday World and Splashin' Safari, as well as a great view from Splashin' Safari too. And you get wonderful looks at it, a beautiful view, and really adds a lot of character to the Halloween section and the 4th of July section of the park. So we think it's adding a lot to the visual appeal, as well as being just a lot of fun to ride, I'm sure. Down a little bit and see a little more of the country. We're talking to you from a part of the structure of the Legend here. This is a piece of the ride where we've on our way back to the station near the end of the ride. One of the ideas that we got from the many coaster enthusiast suggestions that came into us this past spring and summer when we asked for ideas was to put in more crossovers, and that was definitely one thing that we did give instructions and make a request to Denise and Custom Coasters to do for us. And we have added several additional crossovers, including the one just above me and to my right, where we cross over underneath the main lift hill. Mid-course drop. This is a 66-foot drop, and as you can see, we couldn't get the drop quite tall enough, so we had to get some of this nasty dirt out of the way so we get it down a little deeper. This will be covered by a tunnel after the Legend is open, and it will be a nice dark tunnel here on the mid-course drop. I'd like to mention a couple of things. We mentioned Stark Raven Mad May 5th, the night before opening. It'll be an opportunity to come in and ride the Legend and enjoy it the day before we open to the public. We'd also like to remind everyone that ACE convention next summer, and looking forward to hosting everyone, having everybody out. There'll be lots of ERT on the Legend and the Raven, and we're going to have a real good time. Everyone's going to be here, and I think it's going to be a great, great event. I'd also like to mention, as in years past, we're going to have some special deep discounted pricing for members of all coaster clubs, be it ACE or Great Ohio Coaster Club, or I want to go try to make a list because there are far too many, but we will have deep discounted pricing both for daily admission and season passes. And also like to mention something that we're doing that's unique and different and innovative, I might say, in our industry this year, is that beginning this year in the year 2000 at Holiday World and Splashin Safari, with your admission price into the park, every soft drink in the park is going to be free. We're not charging for any soft drinks. So we think it's just another way to be customer friendly, make it easier for people. Our approach has been, we don't want to have a lot of extra charges. We're kind of going the opposite direction that a lot of folks are going. But we like the idea, we don't charge for parking, we don't charge for our water park, we don't charge for inner tubes, and now to all that, we're adding the fact that we don't charge for soft drinks. But to us, it's the right way to do it, and we think it's going to be a great feature for all of our guests next year, and something that everyone in the industry is going to be looking at very closely. Talking to you from the back side of the Legend, right behind me is the Spiral Drop. The Spiral Drop is a 77-foot drop that is about a third of the way through the over 4,000-foot run of the Legend. We're currently standing, again, for those of you who are familiar with Holiday World, we're currently standing just about 50 feet from the splash pool of the Otorongo water slide, and not that much further from the Monsoon Lagoon water play area. We're very excited about this drop, the Spiral Drop. Again, it's a 77-foot drop, and the view from the top is absolutely incredible. It starts off with a very tight radius, and then the radius unwinds as you go through the drop. And it will be the only drop of its kind in the world when it opens on May 6th. But we are very, very confident that this is going to be one of the most remembered and one of the features of the Legend that will be an absolute standout.
We thought we'd bring you up to the top of our Spiral Drop for a quick look around from the very top. We're looking back toward the beginning of the hill. This is the direction the trains will be traveling toward us when the coaster is in operation. And I'm going to pan down where you're going to see the area where the trains will exit from this drop. And now we're looking down, not quite from the top, just a little bit below the crest of the hill, and giving you an idea how tight this curve is at the top. And as you can see, it kind of unwinds and unfolds. But as you begin this curve, you're going to be looking straight off into the woods. And then the curve winds on around and begins the path back toward the rest of the track. It's a heck of a drop. Here's a view from about 3/4 of the way up the lift hill. As you can see, they don't have the side cables on, or the track put in there. I thought about going all the way to the top. I decided I'm going to wait a day or two until I get a little bit more work done up here. Pretty high up there. It's a bit breezy today. There's a look at the first drop. See, we follow right down. There would be a tunnel at the bottom of the first drop. And we'll pan on around. Now we're looking down at the top of the Frightful Falls log flume lift hill. I'm back at Frightful Falls. And then here's the ending track on the Legend. The train will be traveling from your left to right and then out of the frame toward the top and then on around a U-turn back to the station. Larry Bill at CCI said that he really felt like he had to come up with something great to finish this one up because he felt the finish on the Raven was so strong he had to come up with something better for the Legend, and my personal opinion is he has. I guess it'll remain to be seen. We'll get some trains on here and run them around, what everybody thinks, but looks pretty good from where I'm standing.
Legend on this January day here at Holiday World and Splashin' Safari. I'd like to say that thanks to comments, ideas, input from lots of great people, lots of coaster enthusiasts, folks sitting right here in the room watching today, the great minds of Denise Din, Larry Bill, Dennis McNulty, we got a heck of a ride going here. I like to say it looked great on paper as we've watched it being built and assembled here in the woods at Holiday World. Every time a section of it's gone up in the air, I feel that it looks much better up in the air than I dreamed it would on paper. And now all we can do is wait through the long winter days as the ride is finished and think about what those first rides this spring are going to feel like. I, for one, can't wait. I think it's going to be tremendous, and all I can say is I think you're at the ride this one to really understand and appreciate it. I'd like to remind everybody once again, Stark Raven Mad at Holiday World and Splashin' Safari, May 5th, the night before our opening to the public. You'll have a chance to ride the legend before anyone else. And also a reminder to please put on your calendar the ACE convention this summer at Holiday World. We'd love to have you out. We're going to have a great time, lots of ERT on the Raven and the Legend. And I'd like to thank all of you for all of your great support, the wonderful relationship that we've developed with so many, many of you that are here with us today. And again, all we can say is we're really proud of the Legend. And come on out this summer and scream your head off.